Children, welcome back to social science class. I hope you are all fine and safe. Today, let us continue the history's fourth chapter. Today we are going to study the fourth chapter of history. What books and burials tell us. We are going to today, in this class, we are going to study about books, very ancient books of India. Okay. Suresha, tell me, have you been to library? Yes. Okay, very good. What do you read in the library? Shiva, tell me, what do you read? You read newspaper, right. Then magazines, right. Suma, tell me, story books. Yes. Then Sandhya, tell me, yes. They read newspaper, magazines, story books. Then encyclopedia, right? Yeah, you read encyclopedia, yes. Then what type of books are available in library? Story books, okay, right. Then related to history, math, science, geography, even religious books are available in library. In school library you may have Ramayana and Mahabharata books, but religious books also available in library. Today we are going to study one of the ancient book of Hindus or ours, it is, so that is Vedas. We are going to study about Vedas. Okay, what do you mean by Veda? Have you heard, children, Vedas? Veda means some, have you heard some mantras? Right, mantras are hymns, they are very good. Yes, where did you hear this? In the temple, right, good, very good. We can hear this hymns or mantras in temple. Then while performing yagas, yajnas, sometimes during the pujas, right. Then sometimes when we welcome our Swamiji, mantra patana, Veda patana will be there, isn't it? You might have heard it. Yes, same Vedas. Let us learn about these Vedas. Okay, what do you mean by Veda? Veda means knowledge. Veda means knowledge. Full, these books, Vedas are full of knowledge. It is world's oldest book. The oldest book of the world is Vedas. Tell me, Prasad, which is the oldest book? Vedas are the very ancient or oldest book of the world it is. So it is full of knowledge. Vedas are full of knowledge. See, in Sanatana Dharma or Hindu Dharma, the collection of sacred writings, Vedas are the collection of sacred writings, holy writings, holy, we consider it as a holy book. Vedas are holy books of India. So all these Vedas are in Sanskrit language. Which language? Sanskrit language. Very, Sanskrit is the very old or ancient language of India. It was in India from thousands and thousands of years ago. The students or shishyas, they used to learn in the gurukulas. The media of instruction was Sanskrit in those days. English has come recently. It is not ours, it is foreign language. Okay, but it is the need of the day, so we learn it. So Sanskrit is the very ancient language. Then in the Vedas, Vedas are written in a Sanskrit language, and it is the collection of hymns. Vedas are nothing but the collection of hymns. How many Vedas are there, have you heard? Yes, there are four Vedas, right? Very good, children, you know this. How many Vedas are there? There are four Vedas. Can you name them? Yes. Some of you might have heard it. So Rig Veda, Sama Veda, Yajur Veda and Atharva Veda. There are four Vedas. Rig Veda, Sama Veda, Yajur Veda and Atharva Veda. at to see what is in Rigveda. Rigveda is the very ancient one. It was composed around 3500 years ago. Not new one, 3500 years ago it was composed by our rishis, munis or sages. They have composed, they were the scholars, they were the learned person. They composed it in a Sanskrit language and they used to write it on the barks of the leaves, plants or the palm leaves, etc. Okay. See, Rigveda, in that, they praise the gods and goddesses. We worship Ganapati, Saraswati, Shiva, Vishnu, isn't it? In this Rigveda, they have mentioned or praised the gods and goddess, Lakshmi, Saraswati, Devi, Durga, isn't it? So we worship them, goddess, female goddess, isn't it? You know the difference between god and goddess. Yes. Next one is Samaveda. Samaveda explains about medicine and music. It explains about music and medicine. Next, Yajurveda. It all in this, they explain about worship of God, how to do the prayer, how to do the sacrifice, yagas, yajnas, pujas, everything is mentioned in the Yajurveda. Priests, the learned person, scholars, they learn these four Vedas. Atharva Veda, in Atharva Veda, prayer and hymns. Mantras, hymns means mantras, they are in the form of hymns. So four Vedas, some scholars, great scholars, sages, they learn all these four Vedas. Among this, which is the ancient Veda, Shiva, which is the ancient Veda? Rig Veda. Rig Veda is the ancient, very old, oldest Veda. Among all these Vedas, first Veda is Rig Veda. It includes more than 1,000 hymns. How many are there? More than 1,000. 1,000 to nearly 2,000 hymns are there. They are called, these hymns are called Suktas. Suktas. Su means in Sanskrit, good. Su, good. Ukta. Ukti means speak, say, said. So, well said. Suktas or Sukti means well said. This is called Suktas. These hymns are called Suktas. In this book, they praise Agni. We worship Agni, fire, Indra, warrior, Soma, then Surya, sun god, then Vayu, air, what we say, Vayu, Vishnu, and God, goddess Lakshmi, Durga, all these gods are praised in this Rigveda. Yes, which is the very ancient Veda? Rigveda is the very old or ancient Veda. So let us see what is Agni. You might have heard fire, we say the god of fire. Agni means the god of fire. Next, Indra. Some examples we give. Indra. Indra is warrior god. You might have seen in the serials. Nowadays so many serials come. In that you might have heard Agni, Indra, Vayu, Varuna. Isn't it? Soma, all those. Next, Soma is, it is a special drink prepared by the plants. It is prepared in this, they extracted from medicinal plants. The juice which is extracted from medicinal plants is called Soma. So in this Rigveda, hymns composed by sages. Who composed all these hymns? Sages, rishis, munis, scholars. They are the great learned persons. Sometimes you might have seen them. They live big-eared, then they have long hair, tied all those things. Sometimes they wear this saffron attire, all those things you might have seen. Then they taught it to the priests, or priests learnt it. And they taught it to the students. They passed. Priest taught it to the students. It passed from guru. प्रीस्ट और गुरु वी से गुरु टू शिष्य और स्टूडेंट्स टू रिसाइट एंड मेमोराइज लॉन्ग बैक चिल्ड्रन इट वॉज नॉट रिटन ऋग्वेदास वेर नॉट रिटन अर्लियर ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द वेदास वेर नॉट रिटन अर्लियर इट पास्ड फ्रॉम जनरेशन टू जनरेशन ओरली इट पास्ड फ्रॉम जनरेशन टू जनरेशन प्रीस्ट और गुरुज टॉट इट टू द स्टूडेंट्स दे रिसाइटेड एंड मेमोराइज्ड सिस्टमैटिकली विदाउट एनी मिस्टेक they have to recite and memorize all those things. Recently it was printed. It was available in Kashmir, northwest region of India. It was printed only just 200 years ago. See, composed 3500 years ago, but it was not at all written until that. Only just from 200 years ago it was written and later translated into different languages, Sanskrit. It was originally written in Sanskrit to English and other languages. Hymns of Rigveda are in the form of dialogues. Some of the hymns are in the forms of dialogues between two here. See, here in the textbook they have given you a page of this Rigveda. Page of this Rigveda, children, see this. It is found in Kashmir. At present, it is in Pune library. Just we got it 150 years ago. It was written and preserved in Pune library. You can see this in your textbook. Then most of these hymns are in the forms of dialogues between two people conversation. One speaks, one responds, one answers, one asks questions, one replies. So, the dialogue, talk between two people it is. Here is one example between Vishwamitra and two rivers. The rivers are Bees and Sutlej. And even they explain about Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati rivers. Let us see in the map, children. See here. Sutlej river is here, Sutlej. Above that you can see the Bias river, Sutlej, present Punjab state. It is at present Punjab state. Then the sacred river, holy river of India, which is the holy river of India, sacred, we worship the rivers, Gange cha Yamune chaiva, Godavari, Saraswati, Narmada, Sindhu, Kaveri, Jalesmin, Sannidhingur, isn't it? While we take bath, we say all these slokas. That shows rivers are holy for us and we worship it as goddess. See, Ganga river rises Gangotri in Himalaya and flows in the northern India and joins the Bay of Bengal. Yamuna river is here, central India. Yamuna Saraswati, you can't see the Saraswati river, it is not seen nowadays. Okay, so in these Rigveda they have explained about all these rivers and they praised it. Now let us listen. Dear children, here is a conversation between Vishwamitra and rivers. Vishwamitra says, O rivers, come down from the mountains like two swift horses, like two shining cows that lick their calves. You move like chariots to the sea through the power of Indra. You are full of water and wish to unite with one another, the rivers. We, who are full of water, move along the path of gods have made for us. One feast. Start flowing, we cannot be stopped. Why do you pray to us, O sage? Vishwamitra, O sisters, please listen to me. The singer who has come from a distance with his chariots and carts, let your waters not rise above our axles so that we can cross safely. The rivers, we will listen to your prayers so that you can cross safely. See what is written in the Rigveda, children. See,
there are many prayers. I told you they praise the god and the goddess. Afterwards, they praise the rivers. All the Ganga, Yamuna, Vyas and Satluj, the rivers were explained in this Rig Veda. Then later they explain about the cattle, children and horses.
See, cattle is very holy for us children. See, cattle, cat in the Rig Veda they explain about the cattle, small children and even horse. Horse used for chariots.
Horse in Mahabharata you might have seen. Here is one open chariot. Okay, horses were used in the chariots. So, pull the chariots. And they used to fight. Even in those days, they used to fight for land, water and to capture the people.
The person who was brave and skillful will be the leader. There was no kings. There were no kings in those days. So one among them was a leader and they used to fight.
The person who was captured in the battle was called as slaves. Slaves or dasa, they were called dasa. Slaves were called dasa. They used to do the work what they were told by their master after capturing. Okay. Then after the battle, one team will win. One group will win. They get wealth, slaves, land, cattle. Cattle was a wealth for them. So they used to share themselves. First one it was wave portion. One portion was shared, given to their leaders. Next one portion goes to the priests, those who perform the pujas. Next among the common people who participated in the battle, then we made some money they reserved for to perform the sacrifices, yavas, yantras, homas, pujas, all those things to praise the god and goddess. During the yava they offer ghee. You might have seen ghee is needed. Ghee, then grains, some grains, navadanya. They used all the grains. Sometimes even holy sticks are used to perform the yagas. Then there are words to describe the people. How were the common people in those days? It is explained here. See their work according to their word, language, family, culture, community, everything they have divided the society into two parts. One is priests who perform pujas and they are always engaged in the studies, yajnas, they were called brahmins. Next group is rajas. See children, raja means not king. What you read later about the kings, not those kings, common people. Here in Rigveda the word raja comes from the common people. They were called janas or vish. Later the word vaishya is derived from the word vish. Later it was divided as a brahmana, kshatriya, vaishya and shudra. So you learn this in the next class.
Now let us go for homework children. Answer the following questions. Name four Vedas. Right? Which is the oldest Veda? When was it composed? In what ways are the books we read today are different from Rigveda? We read today are different from Rigveda. Rigveda, oral it was, not written earlier, late, it was written later. Okay. Then fill up the blanks. Veda means trash, knowledge, the god of fire, yes, Agni. The hymns are composed by sages. Thank you. Have a nice day.